All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios and welcoming into the studio Tyrone Docherty, the President and CEO of Deerhorn Capital. And Tyrone, great to have you in here. How are you?
I'm real good. Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here.
So we're talking about your gold, copper, and
tellurium.
Tellurium, which is what we'll get into in just a second, but it's right near Smithers, BC. So tell us a little bit about this. This project has a very rich history, actually.
Well, it does, actually. It was founded in 1943 because of its tungsten, the war movement. And of course, the war ended 2 years later, so they disregarded that. They found some copper and did some, gold and did some work in the 60s. And,
yeah.
And it was put on hiatus in 1972, the NDP government, but it was opened up in the mid-80s, and Teck Corporation went in and did 3 years worth of work, including lots of drilling and doing the assay work. So they decided to move on because they weren't sure about what was going to happen politically in the 90s. So they thought it was a wonderful little property, but let's move ourselves elsewhere. So it became available, and the private group took it, and I took it over in 2009. I'm very happy I did because it's a phenomenal property.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about it. What work's been done on there? And you actually put out a PEA just last year.
Yeah, last year we put a PEA. It was a robust economics, what we called, and the BC Securities Commission doesn't like us using the word robust. And I said, well, it's actually not my word. It's from the independent engineer. So basically, it was a 56% IRR. 42% after-tax, 1.6-year payback. And we did our PEA based on only 20% of our known zone, because our thought process, we want to get the property into production using a small mines permit and then use a revenue from that to drill up the rest of the 80% of the known zone, rather than keep drilling and drilling. And then when you're finally finished, it might take you 12 to 20 years to get a permit. So we'd rather see revenue come sooner. And then, you know, we can also look at some of the other deposits on our property, like the copper that we have and the tungsten. So it's very, very exciting. It's very, very unique. And obviously, we have the minerals now. They're needed in the green metals and all that. So we're very lucky that the time is right to be in our minerals.
Explain to us a bit about the small mines permit and how that's going to work there, because that's, I think, a pretty interesting part of this story.
Well, that's been our main focus. In BC, under Section 10, you're allowed to mine up to 75,000 tons a year and qualify under small mines permit. So obviously, you're not doing much environmental damage at all, because, as I say, there's copper mines doing 75,000 tons a day.
Yeah.
So we plan to go in 6 months of the year, mine there in the spring and summer, and come out before the heavy snows hit. And so our CapEx to get it going is like $28.6 billion Canadian. So it's very, very reasonable. And, we're only drilling down to 200 feet, 60 meters. So as the report says, you know, there's chances to hit it below that. But let's just go where we know it's there. You know, when we get into production and make some revenue, we can start drilling wherever we want, not having to issue a whole bunch of shares. That's been our philosophy. We only have 16 million shares, 1/6 million shares out. I'm the largest shareholder. Mm. And, sort of follow my history with Quinto. We develop a story, sometimes takes a little bit longer, but I want to make sure I get rid of all the red flags. And I think we've done that here with great relations with the First Nation. So we're very happy.
Now, tellurium, tell me about this.
Well, tellurium is one of the critical metals. It's either the eighth or ninth rarest metal in the world, same scarcity as platinum. And its main function recently has been in solar panels.
Okay.
And First Solar, who's one of the largest solar companies in the world, uses cadmium telluride, being tellurium, and the other is silica, but they're the leader. And they actually mentioned Deerhorn a few years ago, talking about one of the future potential suppliers of tellurium. But one of the recent innovations in tellurium, as a matter of fact, just came out the other day, our new partner up in Trail, Phoenix Advanced Materials, they work on what they call 7N technology, which is 99.99999% purity. So they like what we're doing, but they're doing research on lithium tellurium batteries, which is the next phase, because it's a solid state battery, not the lithium ion one. So the government of Germany is putting a whole bunch of money into the research. So they contacted us. They like, not only do we have the tellurium, we have some other critical metals that the U.S. government listed in their recent report. We actually have three of them, the 35 on our property. And that doesn't include how copper's really big in the green metals, and some tungsten as well. So it's a great little property, and we can make it bigger, but we just want to nurse it along nicely without having to waste a whole bunch of money drilling for the sake of drilling.
So that leads me to, you know, we're in 2019. So what can people look forward to about Deerhorn over the next year?
Well, over the next year, we've just inked a whole bunch of new partnerships, being the Phoenix Advanced Materials and Trail for the ultra-high purity. But we're also going to look at the copper potential, the copper porphyry potential in our property, which we basically have set aside because we've been concentrating on putting the gold, silver, tellurium into production. But the copper could be a real big story. Everyone in the world is looking for copper porphyries, and the independent engineers in our PEA said that Deerhorn has the potential to host multiple copper porphyry. So sometimes it takes a while to get the hit on the head and say, look over there, but it could be a huge game changer. We expect it to be a huge game changer. And if we prove a copper porphyry, well, then the doors will open and we'll get all kinds of big partners to help advance everything without having to issue too many shares.
Yeah, and that's the key, is you're not actively raising money or anything like that right now?
No, we're going to probably raise a little bit of money in the next little while just so we can get up there and do some of the work on the copper and probably on the tungsten. And also, we just think the phenomenal deal. I think we did mining history a week or so ago with the First Nations partnership that we're involved in. They're going to open up the areas right beside the Golden Triangle. I'm not sure how many square kilometers, if I'm allowed to say it, but it's in the tens of thousands. And just because our relationship with my chairman, Tony Fogarossi, who is a First Nations lawyer, has got great respect from them, and they like the way we do things and protect the environment. So it's very similar to my previous story with Quinto. It took me 11 years, but I'd like to take care of all the red flags, and anyone getting in now, certainly I think they're getting in at a great opportunity.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what happens. And thanks for sharing some time with us. Great to talk to you.
Thank you, Steve.
Enjoyed that. Thanks very much.
My pleasure.
Tyrone Docherty is the president and CEO of Deerhorn Capital.